the Moira River
in Belleville, and there was a vehicle that went into the water on Wednesday night. It's October the 4th.
See a couple of
Belleville fire numbers. This is a membrane that they put around where the vehicle is, and what it does is it protects the waterway from any oil, gas, transmission fluid, antifreeze, windshield washer fluid that could come out of the vehicle as it's being pulled up. It's upside down. A vehicle was driving southbound on Camden Road when it ended up avoiding a vehicle that had backed out onto the roadway.
And from there,
it ended up hitting the bank and going right into the Moira. Now there was one driver, and in the vehicle was
a dog.
Both the driver and the dog were able to make it out safe and sound, shaken up but not injured. And they see that, you can hear them talking, they're pointing that they can see the vehicle. Fire Chief Mark McDonald there. So they're getting close to pulling the vehicle up. There you can see the wheels of the vehicle. So of course the end that's upside down, that's heavier, is going to be the engine end.
Being able to bring it out of the water here.
The tow truck crews, Quinney Conservation on site, a company called Drainall, which specializes in these membranes. And they have the vehicle untamed, which is the good news, which is exactly what they wanted. There is a tremendous amount of pressure on that single cable, as you'll see, the tow truck, but behind it, a flatbed tow truck as well. And they've harnessed the two vehicles together
for the protection and strength as they pull this up.
It is really pulling from that vehicle. The front wheels just a second ago almost lifted up. See the arm moving. They're trying to do everything they can to bring it up straight.
It's no matter what leaks out, whether it's oil or gas, windshield washer fluid, transmission fluid,
antifreeze, it'll stay within this membrane, which is directly below me. Again, we're right there. You see the Quinney Sports and Wellness Center, right to the direct north of where we are. And they've got everything wedged on the two front tires, but again, the heavy end, they need to actually pull up higher than the back end in order to be able to bring this out. And you hear the tension that's on that cable. It's amazing that it's able to pull. And they do have a concern of the cable snapping, so we've been asked to go back a few feet from the vehicle. Belleville firefighter members holding
you
up.
You guys can kind of let it collapse around it. Don't have to work so hard.
And now you can see it's fully afloat. The hardest part of the towing is now done.
Yeah. Now that they've got that up, we can let this kind of collapse around so that everything will come over to this corner.
Okay.
So you don't have to work so hard, Jelly.
Lake Shannon with the fire department.
I'll start bringing this in. Makes the loop smaller.
Yeah, we'll start backing it up.
Right.
Dave, do you want to disconnect that chunk there?
But it's still going to be an angle, so you don't have to. Yeah.
Heard the firefighters say that they smelled fuel, so I was not sure if they're smelling that from the vehicle or from the water itself. So they're keeping that membrane surrounding the vehicle. If you look at the gas tank right there, it is certainly more. It looks like it's got a liquid on it. It could just be the water which it was sitting in all night. Damage to the front of the vehicle there, and that's to be expected. When you think of the fact that these people were able to make it out, the driver safe and sound along with the dog. Again, the angle of the way it's sinking, of course, the water's pouring out the back, but the front is the heavier part, obviously. Basically big sponges to soak up whatever may have dripped. There's going to be a lot of pressure on that cable. You can hear just the fibers in it. Baby steps are going very, very slowly here. Soft surface, and it's got to climb up all those rocks. See the vehicle, just watch it shake. The amount of pressure that this truck has on it right now.
can imagine being in this vehicle when the situation goes down. It would be very frightening having the composure to be able to get out, get your dog out. See, just in the dark there, the battery in front of the front of the vehicle is heavily damaged, but of course now it's being drug up. Roxanne is now out of the water. Every inch now is positive. Just to get it, the environmental concern now is pretty much over. You just look in, I know it's hard to see, there's actually just a sandwich container in the vehicle. It's amazing how quickly things can change. Wheels and try and turn it around.
It looks like they're going to go
to the one side and turn it around. Let's see if they can get it from the front axle to the rear axle. There's something that they can attach it to. And if they can, it should be able to turn
around. Pull it sideways up. And so they're just letting out some line now.
So they can hook right back onto that spot. So they got the sponges down. And of course, you see around there's certainly a crowd gathered. Now there's been a traffic issue all day, at least to this point, right before the noon hour. People want to look and see what's going on, of course. So we'll tighten it up. And this is likely going to slide the vehicle. This guy will get off the truck now. And now this is going to change the angle of the vehicle and how it gets pulled up. any of the... I saw this earlier. The protective membrane they put around the vehicle. Just to keep any
liquids from coming out of the car, whether it be
gas or antifreeze. Around 8:30, a vehicle was trying to avoid a car backing out onto Caniffton Street. It swerved and ended up going up the bank into the Moira River. Now, the driver and dog were able to make it safe and sound out and to the side of the bank. However, the vehicle did sink, and they've been able to extricate the vehicle out of the water. They had to put a membrane around the vehicle so that in case there was any transmission fluid or gas or oil, anything leaking, they were able to keep it environmentally safe. But the vehicle is now on the side of the bank. They're going to flip it over and take it away. But again, Environmental Services, Quinte Conservation, Belleville Police, Belleville Fire, all on scene, along with towing to get this vehicle out of the Moira River. And again, 197 Caniffton Road, right between College Street and the Quinte Sports and Wellness Center. Tim Durkin for Quinte News at the Moira River. Quick update for the radio station there. So again, the environmental side, they're able to pull the vehicle from a lower position. So hooked on, and they've got elevation on their side right now. Vehicle spun around. And it looks like they're going to try and pull it out to the back. Talking about putting hooks on the back of this vehicle. Oh. only a matter of time till that vehicle comes over. The window's likely to crack just with the sheer pressure. And the Kia Spectra is now flipped onto its side. And almost over. And once they get it over, it's just going to be a matter of bringing it down the hill. If they can shift everything, they should be able to get it over, but they have to get it over to 51% of the weight till it eventually will rotate. But now they're going to try and get a different handle on it here. So they're just shifting where the hooks are going on, so they're going to put it on the front. Cable right now, they'll strengthen that. And they're grabbing the okay again to start pulling. So we'll see if they can get this, but this is a good amount of work for this vehicle.
Successful in this one.